footage you just saw was from both my short film and from several tests that I did before the film. I led with those things because I think it's important to show why something is cool before explaining the thing itself. This is my ghetto little anamorphic adapter. I created it for Abigail, my short film that I'm still talking about. Now, why did I have to make my own? There's three reasons. One, I'm poor. B, what I wanted didn't seem to really exist, and for some good reasons. And three, I wanted anamorphic oval bokeh in my movie. Quick primer on bokeh, it's this stuff. I wanted it to go from this to this. Simple enough, right? If you want to find out more, Google bokeh and you'll have more information than you could ever possibly remember. I'll put the word on screen so you can spell it. Now to start. I made two different adapters, but for this video we're going to focus on the second one. I made one front mount adapter for my longer lens and one rear mount for my wider lens. The front mount adapter was made first, and it was based on the VidAtlantic adapter. It works for 85mm or larger lenses. I was using a smaller sensor, so for me that was about 50mm. But it doesn't work for wide lenses, which is a major shortcoming for me personally. For this section of the movie, I wanted to shoot on a 16mm lens, which is hella wide anyway, let alone when you want to add an adapter to it that would vignette the sides. So I decided I'm going to try and build something that would be small enough and thin enough to fit between the sensor and the rear element. Which was really, really tricky. After some R&D, I landed at a pretty good result for myself. The R&D was just troubleshooting how large or small the opening had to be, vignetting and blooming the highlights in an appealing way, and all that kind of stuff. It was very much just to taste. To add the bloom, I added a small piece of flat plastic. It catches the light and lets it fall off in this really nice way I enjoy. I toyed with various materials, but I ended up going with a microfiber cloth, post-it notes, and tape, of all things. Then I took it out to test. After some tweaking, which largely involved playing with the plastic and trying it with and without the extra layers of post-its, I had my adapter. Now, since it's literally just paper and microfiber cloth, it's extremely modular and very, very cheap to replace if you, I don't know, accidentally fold a piece of paper roll. You can try placing fishing wire on the back to get that beautiful streaking effect if that's your thing, but I decided against it for this movie. The look I wanted in my film was very specific, but really hard to describe. It made sense in my head. But to describe it would say I want it to look like the memory of Super 8 film, but also early color film, but also a Western, but also Oh Brother Where Art Thou, but also The French Connection, but also The Revenant. Again, it makes sense in my head, very, very difficult to get out into the world until you can actually show it to someone. I also have to clarify, this obviously won't squeeze your image, which is fine for me, but some people might want to be reminded of that. For this shoot, I wanted a very tall image, I wanted it to fill the screen, but with the beautiful anamorphic bokeh and bloomed highlights, similar to a black ProMist filter, but about $80 cheaper. I think I succeeded for what I wanted, and I hope this kind of template can help you give a unique look to your film, or maybe just use it for something else. For Abigail, I built a front mount one, but from now on, I think I'm going to be using this rear element. Because it's universal, I can put it on any type of lens without worrying about thread size or anything like that. If you'd like any more information, you're more than welcome to message me on this, comment below, all that stuff.